In this tutorial, you'll learn about 5 alternate choices for deployment workflows and some variations on each of those 5. You'll understand how DataRobot uses the terms custom and external in our documentation when referring to models or environments that are not our own. This is important because choice and flexibility in deployments is a key strength of DataRobot's AI production platform. Offering all these alternative workflows is how we make the single pane of glass for AI production and MLOps possible. With DataRobot AI Production, you can deploy models written in any open source language or library and expose a production quality REST API to support real-time or batch predictions, all with monitoring, management, and governance. There are many possible model development tools, languages, frameworks, and IDEs. Some of the most common are listed here in the top half. There are many possible deployment environments, including all the major cloud platforms, Snowflake, OpenShift, Kubernetes, at the edge, and other options. DataRobot is flexible to deploy anything you've created using the tools on the top to the infrastructure listed on the bottom. This table in the DataRobot documentation summarizes the workflows that are currently possible. These hyperlinks will take you to more information about each, including flowcharts. Workflow option number 1 is to deploy a DataRobot model to a DataRobot prediction server. This means you've used DataRobot's AI experimentation to create the model, have registered the model, and are deploying that to a DataRobot prediction environment. That seems very simple to explain, but it can get confusing because your DataRobot software itself might be installed in AWS, GCP, Azure, or on-premise. When you see DataRobot prediction environment on this slide and in the docs, we mean the servers that have been provisioned as part of your DataRobot software. The second workflow is to deploy a DataRobot model to an external prediction server. Here, our use of the word external signifies that it is outside your DataRobot software. The workflow is to develop with AI experimentation, bring the model into the model registry, and then deploy it externally. 3 specific options to be aware of are the portable prediction server, Java scoring code, and Snowflake Java UDF. The 3rd option is specific to Snowflake, while the other 2 will work with multiple external prediction environments. Back in the documentation, the scoring code option corresponds to row 5 in this table. The portable prediction server option corresponds to row 2. The Snowflake-specific option is covered in another section dedicated to Snowflake only. The 3rd option is to deploy a custom model to a DataRobot prediction server. Here, the use of the word custom refers to any model produced without using DataRobot's AI experimentation. A common open source combination is Python inside a Jupyter notebook. But if your organization has invested in any of the tools shown here, they can all be used to create models. The custom model comes into the model registry and then can be deployed to the DataRobot prediction server. Remember from before that your DataRobot software might itself be running on AWS, GCP, Azure, or on-premise. The 4th option is to use the DataRobot model registry to deploy a custom model to an external prediction server. Again, the use of the word custom means that the model was developed outside of DataRobot AI experimentation. And the use of the word external means that the environment is entirely separate from your DataRobot software. The custom model comes into the model registry and then is deployed externally. The portable prediction server is the typical method for accomplishing this. That workflow corresponds to row number 4 in this table. The 5th option is to use a deployment process that does not involve DataRobot's model registry. Models deployed practically anywhere can be monitored with monitoring agents. This 5th workflow is named External Model in External Environment, and it is described in row 6 of the workflows table. Now you should have a conceptual understanding of the flexibility of the DataRobot AI production platform for managing and monitoring all of your organization's models across many environments. Other tutorials are available to demonstrate the steps for each of the workflow choices.